My name is Slawek Putyrski. I'm principal engineer working at Intel site in Gdańsk, Poland. And I would like to welcome you to the presentation about the NVMe over fabrics, focusing on the management aspect of this technology. And why? Because of a few reasons. First one, you probably have seen already many presentations about the NVMe fabric itself. The second, more personal, I'm the management guy, so manageability is my area of expertise. And the third, most important, I'm participating in the SNIA work on the storage management, and chair of my group asked me to focus on the management, not the technology, but rather on the management. So let's get started. So going through the agenda, I would like to give you some very, very short refresh about the NVMe technology, followed by even shorter intro to the NVMe over fabrics. And then I would like to focus on the main part, which is the management of the NVMe over fabrics with the special focus on phishing. What phishing is and how it is related to the management of the NVMe over fabrics, I will tell you in a few minutes. And then some summary at the end. I know this is the last presentation and some of you, maybe not even all, are thinking about the dinner, so I promise to be fast. So let's get started. Some refresh about the NVMe technology. So as you know, the NVMe technology is the open collection of standards developed by NVMe Express organization to allow full benefits of the non-volatile memory access in all types of the computing, from mobile through the personal computing till the data center equipment. The NVMe Express organization prepared three specifications that defined NVMe technology as an entire technology. First of them is the base specification, which defined register interface and command set for PCIe attached storage. It is widely seen as, in fact, the industry standard for the PCIe-based SSDs. The second is the NVMe Express Management Interface Specification, NVMe-MI. This specification defines the command set and architecture for out-of-band management of NVMe Express storage. This management is performed through the dedicated management bus, I2C or SM bus, and performed by the dedicated board management controller, BMC, mainly in the data center environment where the BMCs are commonly used. And the third specification, most important for us, this is NVMe over fabrics specification. It is extension of the base NVMe spec that defines the method how tunnel the NVMe commands to extend the benefits of the non-volatile access beyond just the PCIe transport. So, NVMe. So shortly saying, the NVMe is the specification that defines the PCIe to access to the PCIe-based SSDs, assuring the low latency access to NVMe non-volatile memory devices from the multiple clients simultaneously using the modern set of the commands through the multi-queue interface. So this is the shortest possible definition of the NVMe technology. And the commands are provided to the devices separately through the command queue as a command, as administrative commands, and also the IO command separately from the administrative, allowing full separation of the data path and control path. And because the NVMe is de facto the standard for PCI-based SSDs. It is supported by most, I even say all, major operating system, various Linux distribution, Windows, desktop and clients, ASX, probably even by most of the mobile operating system as well. So NVMe multi-queuing interface, this is the main part of the, and its definition is the main part of the NVMe Express base specification. This specification defines the queuing interface that allows full benefit access of the to the NVMe in different environments. The definition is done through the queues that are built as a queue pairs with the submission and completion queue, and also with the possibility of the building of the multiple groups with the single completion queue supporting multiple submission queues. This queuing interface allows us to assign the separate command source to the separate queue pairs. This allows us to very efficiently use the media because of independent access of the clients to the media through the separate dedicated queues. And also, this technology allows to perform the full per-core interrupt steering, allowing very efficient access and very perform-oriented access to the media. So the queue processing is looks exactly the same, despite of where it is placed. The host driver submit the queue through the submission queues, notify the controller. Controller receive this queue from the submission queue and process the commands, depending if this is the I/O commands or the administrative command, and then return the results of the commands to the completion queue, notify the host driver, and the driver receive this command from the completion queue, and this ends entire NVMe operation. So the queuing functionality is always present in any implementation of the NVMe functionality. The difference is where it takes place. For the PCIe-based SSDs, this is the host memory where the PCI device has direct access to, or this is the NVMe controller or subsystem if we talk about the NVMe over fabrics. So that's why we have gone smoothly from the local PCI devices to the NVMe over fabric. So why NVMe fabrics? NVMe fabrics preserve the same queuing, very efficient queuing interface that has been defined for the NVMe devices and extend its usage beyond just the PCI interface. PCI is quite great technology, but it is most efficient for the locally attached devices access. So, simply saying, it is good technology for the to be used within the single system or the system that are physically co-located because of the limitation in the cabling length of the PCI cables. Extending the usage of the NVMe beyond the PCIe, which is provided by the definition of the NVMe over fabric specs, extend the access beyond the PCIe to different type of the fabrics, allowing the same benefits of the NVMe memory access. By natural, it support multipathing capabilities where there were multiple source systems use the same device within the target system through separate dedicated queues. And the NVMe-aware fabrics allow define the methods how to tunnel these commands through different types of the fabrics. It could be the Ethernet, RDMA, Rocky V2, IWARP, this could be the TCP IP, this could be the fiber channel, any type of the fabrics. And the NVMe fabrics is also the great technology, probably the best technology right now to build the network storage systems, allowing efficient sharing of the devices with this multipathing capability, allowing full and optimal utilization of the capacity. As you know, in the typical locally attached devices are fully unutilized in the typical environment. The utilization is roughly 50%. So network storage provides the ability to better utilize the capacity. And of course, the NVMe fabrics as a network storage technology allow efficient workload migration using the same data stored on the networking storage systems within the data center or the cloud environment. Efficient usage of the NVMe over fabrics requires the method to efficiently manage those solutions. And this management model should be characterized with two things. One should be easy to be implemented, and another one should be highly interoperable because of the disaggregated nature of the NVMe fabrics, should support the interoperability between the compute and storage systems from different hardware vendors. So to do management of the NVMe fabrics, the best way seems to be usage of the logical fabric management model, which could be highly independent from the transport and characteristics of the fabric, using the same model for management of PCIe fabric, Ethernet fabric, fiber channel, and the fabric technologies that we may have. So to do this, we need to define some part of the logical model. So we need to define the management points. The management points should be the initiator system, where the commands are created and operation is initiated. We need to have the target system where the commands is processed and operations is performed. And we should be also able to manage the fabric infrastructure, so all the interconnectivity equipment that provides the connection between the initiator system and target system. For the management purposes of the NVMe fabric, we need to define some data structures that should be also logical and should represent some devices that are physically located within the systems for the purposes of the fabric access. We call them fabric endpoints. So fabric endpoints logically represents the devices within the particular system to the fabric and to the other systems connected to the fabric. Those endpoints should be uniquely identified within the domain of the particular fabric and should contain all information necessary to establish the connection over the fabric and apply some access rules on the fabric connections. The perfect model should support different classes of fabrics, should support port-based fabrics, where the information how to establish connection between initiator and target systems is just the port. This is the PCI, this is the CXL, and other technologies like this. And the perfect logical management model should also support addressable fabric. Addressable fabric, this is the type of the fabric where in addition to the fabric interface, fabric ports, you need to establish connection, you need to provide some additional information like address information. The perfect example is of course the Ethernet and IP addressing plus TCP or UDP ports. To establish connection over the fabric, the initiator needs to know information about the targets that has been assigned to the particular initiators. And vice versa, target. And the first one is initiator simply needs to know what to access where. Target needs to know information about the initiator data, initiator endpoints data, simply to know who can access what on the particular system. So how to apply this logical management model to NVMe over fabrics? Of course, we have the management points, we have initiator endpoints, we have target endpoints. We may have an optional fabric management. Optional because there are many fabrics that doesn't require any runtime configuration in addition, done for the infrastructure, of course, in addition to some initial configuration performed during deployment of the equipment. And we need to have the initiator endpoints, which typically represents the computer system, hardware and software, depending on the implementation of the initiator. Of course, there should be other devices that can work as the initiator, devices like SmartNICs, for example, or FPGA-based implementations. But typically, currently, in most of the implementations, the initiator is just the computer system. And of course, the target endpoints, which represents or expose the NVMe subsystem or namespace over the fabric. And fabric endpoints for the purposes of the NVMe over fabric shall, of course, support all the requirements for the initiator. And for the NVMe over fabrics technology, we have the initiator identifier, which is the NQN. We need to have the transport information, which is the type of the fabric, protocol, some additional address information. We need to have the fabric port definition and information, for example, the Ethernet interface located within the initiator system or target system. And of course, some information about the represented devices represented by the particular endpoint, which is the computer system in the case of the initiator endpoint, and the NVMe subsystem or namespace in the case of the target system. The management of the NVMe over fabrics is by nature the management of the distributed systems, separate physical systems located independently of each other. So this is, from the management standpoint, this is quite complex problem, how to manage those. We need to provide management interfaces, all those systems that should be accessible through the dedicated connectivity. We should provide functionality of the discovery of the managed subsystem, as well as we need to have some management software that is implemented and run on all those systems that allow management access. To simplify the management of the NVMe fabrics, the NVMe Express organization, as a part of the NVMe fabrics specification, prepared the concept of the discovery service. The idea behind the discovery service is that it is the service or system which is exposed to the fabric by the endpoint of the predefined well-known identifier, which doesn't need to be configured in the runtime because it can be hard-coded in the management software, and allow configuration of all systems participating in the NVMe fabric configuration, not through the dedicated management interfaces as presented previously, but through this discovery service. So the entire configuration is applied to the discovery service, and discovery service is responsible for applying part of those configuration to all systems that's built the fabric. And this configuration is applied not through the control path, but through the data path. So using the regular transport, regular connections that the fabric supports. This connection is established between the initiator or target system, in fact, all system and the discovery service. The most current definition of the NVMe-oF fabric spec, which is 1.1, defined this discovery service to support Ethernet RDMA and TCP transports, and defined this as a persistent service. So the connection between the systems are established with the discovery service, and discovery service is responsible for notifying those systems about all changes done for the configuration of the particular system. So now let's go fishing. So what is fishing and how it is related to NVMe-oF fabrics management? So I would like to provide you with the information about two fish. One is redfish, another one is swordfish. So there are management standards. First one is the redfish. Redfish is the infrastructure management standard defined and maintained by DMTF, the Distributed Management Task Force Organization. It is defined as the hierarchical management model with JSON structures and all data schemas. It's defined as the secure REST API that separates management model from the transport, which is simply HTTPS. And in addition to the fabric management, it provides much wider set of the managed devices. It's seen commonly as a successor to the IPMI, so the out-of-band management interface for the compute, but provides much more functionalities. Another fish is swordfish. Swordfish is the standard developed by SNIA, which extends the redfish to provide the capability for management of the logical storage systems with extended definition of classes of services. Both swordfish and redfish use the same concept of the hierarchical model, use the same concept of the encoding of the data structures, the same set of the schemas. So they are fully interoperable that allow implementer to use both simultaneously, building the management solution for the single system. We can use resources and parts of the definition defined by redfish and swordfish together without any problems. So now let's focus how the fabric management model defined by redfish and swordfish looks like. In this hierarchical model, as I mentioned before, all the resources are defined as a vertical model with the horizontal references providing information about the associations between the managed objects. The entry point to entire hierarchy is the object called service route, which contains information about collection of all managed resources within the particular system. Despite if this is the target system, initiator system, or even the global resource manager. One of the collection within the service route is collection of the fabrics. And the single fabric define the one instance of the fabric of the different type. If we talk about NVMe Fabric, this is just the one instance of the fabric, one domain of the fabric. To define this, we need to have three sub-hierarchies of the fabric model. First one is the hierarchy of fabric infrastructure management. As I mentioned before, it is optional and consists of the switches and ports of those switches. The second is the collection of endpoints. The collection of endpoints, every endpoint represents some resources that are available, accessible over the fabric. And endpoint should contain all information necessary to access, first establish the connection to the fabric system and then access the resource on the system connected to the fabric. The proper configuration of the fabric consists at least of two endpoints. One is the initiator endpoints, which represents the resource one available over port one of the fabric, and the target endpoint, which represents the resource two over the port two. Of course, in typical configuration, there is many endpoints within the particular fabric domain. So to limit, and not all those endpoints are allowed to talk to each other, because there are some rules that limit the access between the connectivity between the endpoints. And to model this access limitation, we need to have the third sub-hierarchy, which is the definition of zones. So zone is the fully logical construct that defines the boundaries and access rules that apply to all endpoints that belongs to the zone. It can be implemented, but has not to be implemented as a zone which is available with some technology like fiber channel or SAS. And all those resources definitions build the full management model that allow efficient NVMe over fabric management, which is logical model with all the benefits that I mentioned before. Especially, it can be used for different type of the fabrics. Port-based PCIe, addressable fabric, RDMA, fiber channel, everything. So on this slide, you can see the Redfish, Swordfish, JSON data structure, which define the initiator endpoints. As you can see, this endpoints represents the computer system working as the initiator on the fabric and contains all the information necessary to define the endpoints, which is identifier, NQN, which is the endpoint role, which is the initiator. We have the information about the device type, which is the computer system. This is the funny things here, because in Redfish computer system, value in the enum type for the entity type is root complex. This is some historical reason. The first fabric defined by Redfish was PCI. And as you know, from the PCI perspective, computer system is just the PCI root complex. Of course, we have the information about the fabric port, which is the network controller. We have information about the transport protocol, RoCE V2, RDMA, IWARP, RoCE, whatever. Of course, also TCP. And some additional address information, because this Ethernet is addressable fabric, so this is IPv4 address and port number. And of course, as I mentioned before, the endpoint should contain information about the device, which is represented by the particular endpoint, and this is done through the link in the endpoint definition, pointing that this endpoint expose the system one on the fabric. Similarly, this picture shows you the target endpoint with all the information necessary to define the target endpoint. As you see, this endpoint expose the single NVMe namespace over the fabric. And similarly to the initiator side, contains the identifier, contains the information about the role. This is the target endpoint. Contains the information about the device type, which is the storage volume. Storage volume is also the data object that is used to model the NVMe namespaces. All information related to the transport with the transport type and address, and also the link to the device which is exposed over the fabric by this endpoint, which is the volume one on the storage system one. So as I mentioned before, the NVMe management model and Swordfish and Redfish doesn't allow us to model not only the fabric, but all the resources and technologies that can be used in the computing environment. So on this picture, you can see the full diagram of the very simple fabric model that consists of the fabric definition, consists of the definition of the initiator computer system. Simplified for the purposes of this presentation, I just mentioned that the Redfish allow us to build more sophisticated models of the computer system with the separate definition and separate objects managing the different subcomponents and components of the computer system, processors, memory, network interfaces, storages, etc. And also we have the storage subsystem model with the NVMe subsystem and namespaces. As you can see in this diagram shows the view for the NVMe solution as is seen from the central management point, let's say the global resource manager. This manager by nature knows everything about all systems that are managed within the entire domain. This is why the global view for the management model contains all the information and all the association between the endpoints and the devices that are exposed by the endpoints on the fabric. NVMe subsystem or namespace within the target endpoint and the computer system working as the initiator. The role of this global resource manager is to manage different systems that are connected to the fabric, and it should apply part of this as a part of the connection, establishment and configuration of the infrastructure, should apply part of this entire model to the different systems that work within the NVMe-oF fabric domains. And this diagram shows how the global model is narrowed down to the definition and configuration of the initiator side. As you can see, there are available information about the resources exposed on the fabric at the initiator side, but the information about the target resources is missing because this configuration is applied to the initiator side and the initiator system doesn't have any knowledge about the resources located on the target system. This is why those references are empty, but all information which is necessary to establish connection to the target side is included in the endpoints, including the role and type of the devices accessible over the fabric at the target side. Similarly, at the target configuration, We have all information about the local devices, which is the entire storage subsystem with the NVMe subsystem, namespaces, also the information about the interfaces that works as the fabric interface, but we don't have information about the initiator side because those resources are located on the initiator system. But again, this information is not necessary because everything that target system needs to know to properly verify if the initiator system which attempts to connect to the resources on the target side is allowed to do this is included in the initiator endpoints. And also the third system that is possible to be present in the NVMe fabric domain, which is the discovery service, is typically run separately from the initiators and targets, for example, on the dedicated management platform. So it doesn't have any knowledge about any physical devices located in both target or initiator systems, but it has all information about the fabric configuration with all definition of all endpoints and zones, which can be applied to and transferred to the systems working within the fabric domain through the fabric using the data path without any dedicated interface. So, summarizing, this is not my feet on the Tel Aviv beach, but this is quite appropriate, quite appropriate picture. What I would like, you to remember from this presentation, except of course this beautiful Tel Aviv beach, is there are three things. One is redfish and swordfish specifications. Define the logical fabric management model that can be used for NVMe over fabrics management. Second, the single model allow management of various NVMe over fabrics type. Ethernet, RDMA, TCP, fiber channel, almost everybody. And it's easily extendable, so we can even think about the future extension covering different transports. Because as you saw, the transport related part is very, very, very minimal. And the third, same model can be used for management of all fabric connected systems and services. Initiator systems, target systems, discovery systems or services, and also management from the global central management point. So, let's go fishing, where I would like to say outside, just on the beach, but that's unfortunately not the truth. The truth is that at dmtf.org/redfish and the snia.org/swordfish. That's it. Thank you.